Hi everybody, this is my camper trailer, my A-liner camper trailer. A few mods that I've done, like putting two 9 kilo gas bottles on there. Oh, it's actually 8.5 as it says right there. I've got a little lock for the tow bar thing over here that you can't put a tow bar in there. I know it's easy just to cut the lock off, but it's better than having nothing. A larger jockey wheel with a larger wheel on it. When it's on the ground, it's a lot easier to move it when it's on dirt and that, and it just folds back up. Pull the handle, turn the wheel 90 degrees, it's up out of the way. One solar panel up there, it's 150 watt off eBay. They class them as a semi-flexible, so I've just glued it on, not totally glued all the way around, still water can run out of it. Around here I have a closed drying rack. Because if you put towels and that on that one, if you've got any dirt in your trailer, your towels and that get dirty or whatever you've got on the clothesline. So there's a small one there and one on the back there, of course. If you have got the annex arms, you've got to unpop them, get the stainless rod, 8mm, bend it and put it in there. You can't get it out. I had to unpop that and pop it back on again with pop rivets. And then obviously you put that there, stop it from rattling on here, wearing. Right, so that's there. As you can see in the axle, I have raised it because the axle now is turned. Won't zoom in. You can see the axle there, the arm's turned down. So I cut the old brackets off, welded the new ones on. Raise it, and it looks fantastic. As you can see here, it's there, 10 centimeters, and larger tires, largest tires you can put on a 14 inch rim. Looks out really good. Here I've got my rear sliders so I don't tear the stabilizer legs off. They slide on the ground there, it doesn't really matter it no more. I do take it off road, I can now. LED lights here. The original ones got rusted, and yeah, just totally rusted all the way. Same as the rear tail lights, I put LED ones on them because the original ones got water in them. The globes just rusted out, the bracket was all rusted. Yeah, it was a lot easier just to get them two LEDs. Got some stainless plate there and put on there. It's all good. Got a reversing camera because obviously you can't see when you're going behind. That comes in very handy. Little bracket like that, screwed on down to there. Just screw onto there, all easy. Another solar panel up there, which goes underneath the top roof there. It doesn't touch anything because there's no wear marks on it. I've had it up there for 2 years now. Works fantastic. Along here, I put the water outlet right here. Works fantastic there. I've got a centrifugal water pump just there. It works fantastic. I've had that also there for 2 years in muddy sort of water, rain, whatever. It all works fantastic. Much better than the original one, because which was too damn noisy. I've got two fans in here which blow the cool air in, hot air out here to keep the fridge working great. It works fantastic. I got the solar panels off eBay, of course, where everything comes from. Solar panels off eBay, the water pump, eBay. All the things in here, eBay. I got my power switch here, my light switch here. I use these LED lights, LED light strip, they're called. You buy them in 5 meter lengths. So I put two of them up there. These lights work fantastic because the whole trailer is white on the inside, so it reflects light very good. It actually works too good. I had to get a dimmer put on there because they were just too bright at night. The dimmers, oh now the bloody sun's in the way. So I put a radio over there rather than in the spot here. I got a temperature controller here, inside and out. Oh, you can't see it. Yes, you can. So the radio's there. One speaker there, a 240 outlet, a 12 volt outlet. All these have little lights, LED strip lights in them. Have a little switch there. And here, I put two shelves in there. Moved the clothes pole from there across to where it is now. Gained a lot more. I haven't lost anything. You can see how big the radio is. The other one's the same. A lot of room with nothing in it. Under here is the salt, the lithium batteries. Two. The little light comes on again. Two 100 amp hour lithium batteries with the DC to DC charger, which works when I'm driving or when I'm camped. It uses the solar panels, obviously. Well, obviously during the day, of course. A 2000 watt inverter from a 240 power. There's plenty more room under the front there. I put a number of other little tools in there as well, take it with me. The temperature controller for the fan, to cool the DC to DC charger, because it's in an enclosed area, so it needs air circulating over it. Here we've got our switch for our inverter. That now the power's on. You can't quite see the microwave lights come on because it's Yeah, I don't know if you can see that there now. And I've got me a voltmeter for me batteries. Right, that's all. It all works fantastic. As you can see, my bed, it always stays like this. Even though I've raised the whole bed 15 centimeters, which I've gained a lot more room under the bed there. As you can see, it was originally along here. So I've put this extra wall in. Now I have these two containers here that fit perfectly. They're two 40 liter containers I got from Bunnings. There's another two that go here. The part here where I keep the Medunas, and it just makes them nice and clean there. Underneath that is all the storage for the outside access, which has the outside table, a chair, things like that. There's other things inside here. I do not have any 240 inlet to this trailer. I've taken that all out, as I don't need it. I have my 240 air fryer. Bloody sun. There. Here's my air fryer there. A bit more room underneath there. I have another box underneath here. It was all cut, a few car stuff. Oil filter, diesel filter. So that all works good there. And yeah, that's about it really. The drawers. As you can see, you can't see it again. Well, I've raised it, lengthened it 12 centimeters there. Because inside here there's plenty of room. There you got the 240 outlet there, so that one has to stop there. But as you can see from I've raised the second drawer 15 centimeters. So that's given it heaps of room. Get rid of this radio, it's too damn noisy. Yeah, so that was a great advantage doing that. You can get a lot more stuff in there. As you can see, my drawer is full. And I got this made up, so where you can keep all that in there and you still have access, a lot more room down there. Just a matter of putting some wood slides there and one there. And I made this out of like 6mm ply. Well, I actually got a guy from work to make it for me. And it all fits in there perfect. I've done like 10,000 Ks of bouncing around and it all works bloody great. A bit of dust gets in, but otherwise it's all good. Yeah, okay, see you later then.